Good job today with the dancers that you have. Wow. Blessing, huh? But listen to this. A worship that doesn't change us or propel us to obey God more is not worship at all. You see, worship is beyond singing. Worship is telling God, Lord, I come close to you, change me, and whatever you want me to do after the service, I will follow you. Worship without obedience to God's word does not make an impact in heaven. Kaya pala magsumasamba ka, pero may commitment ka rin. You know, unless atin tumakas na kamay, it's a given. Kanya-kanya yan. I remember some person came to me and said, basta bakit yung mga ibang tao pag tumakas ng gawin, ganito po. Iba ko sa kaba, nakita ka ng video, sayang naman. I love you, Lord. Hanggang dyan lang, hanggang dyan. I love you, Lord. Aba, next week, tumakas ka. And I need my Lord. Well, okay, ha? Tumakas ka. To worship. Oh, amen. Sabi ni Bob, wow! From this to that! Ang laki na ng improvement mo! Tapos sabi ni Bang Kalbatin, wala yan. Next week, panoorin mo ko! There is nothing wrong in lifting our hands. The book of Psalms said. But if you're lifting it just an act for other people, God is not honored. Kailangan nyo from the heart. Pero nyo, sometimes when you know the songs, kailangan kumikit ka. Bakit ka kumikit? Bakit? Dahil mapakit yung kanta? Hindi. Kumikit ka. Kasi sometimes yung focus mo, nawawala. Kaya alam nyo sa churches, dapat they know this right now. Pag-uupo ka, pag nang-uupo sa likod, unless may anak pa. Sa harap ka malaki. Sa harap. Kasi yung mga tao nasa unahan mo, kung ano-ano ang ginagawa. At pag nag-worship ka, nag-distract ka. Nagpapasa ng tubig doon, nagpapasa ng store. Alam nyo ba, kung gano'ng kaingay ang store pag pinuksan nyo, napakaingay eh. May papahit, may uubo, may kukuha ng kape. Nadidistract ka. Kaya next Sunday, doon ka sa harap. Sabihan mo na si Brother Adonis doon, kahit hindi ka praise and worship. Bakit? Because you're fighting for focus on God alone. Nothing wrong in raising hand as long it comes from the heart. And brothers and sisters, when you raise your hand to the Lord, sabi mo rin kay Lord, Lord, as I raise and worship my hand on you, I will obey you. Iba yung raising ng raising, wala namang pagbabago. Basta gulero pa rin, gossiper pa rin. Kung si sister mo, taas-taas ka pa, sumano mo ng ugali. Somebody has said these words. Pastor, talaga nagsasabi ng totoo. Somebody has said these words. The greatest testimony we have out there is after the worship service. Totoo yan. People will see you how you act. Right now, behave kayo eh. Right now, nasa talo na kayo. No, sister, ayaw. Good side ko lang. Kailangan makunan. Medyo behave. Medyo, oh. Yan. Tingnan, yan. Okay. Pero pagtapos ng service, kamusta na ang testimony natin? Ha? Mas nakumuna ba tayo sa bisita bago kumain? Mas nakumuna ba tayo umalis bago sa bisita? Kailangan lang testimony natin na na-maintain pa rin. Kasi true Christianity is measured not during church. Kasi pag during church, lahat Christian eh. E pag labas mo sa parking lot, Christian ka pa ba? Baka mami, may masakas na akanta na dyan bata. Relax ka lang, brad. Easy. I hope you catch that, brothers and sisters, right? When we worship the Lord, talaga ang intention mo ay obedience din. Hindi malakasan ang kanta. Malakasan ang pusong handang sumunod kay Lord. That is what worship is all about. Amen? That's why the Bible is telling us here, we need to gather to communicate. Amen. Second thing is this, we need to gather to celebrate God's presence. Because worship is the submission to the nature of God. And mind you, worship never only happens on a Sunday. Can we get an amen? It can happen every day. As you decide to do it for God. Pastor, lima po ang anak ko. Tatlo po ang magulang ko. Ha? Tatlo ang magulang mo? Opo, kasi may wampong po sa akin. Hindi, tatagpon ako na talagang magulang ko. Kaya ako tatlo. Pastor, dalawa po ang trabaho. Pastor, panggabi ako. But listen to this. Isn't it the things that we love because we love it? Even though we don't have time, we make time for it. With our kids. Alam mo, pagod ka. But your kids would like to go out to the park or go out in the beach. God bless you. Pero you need to make time for it. The 24 hours never adds. You have to work on that principle. Kaya pag mahal mo isang tao, kahit pagod ka, kahit busy ka, gagawa ka ng paraan. Can we get an amen? The same thing with the Lord. Gagawa tayo ng paraan. Pastor, sakit po ng ngipin ko. Hindi po ako makakapunta sa simbahan. Tumawa. Brad, baka naman pwedeng Monday na lang sumakit ang ngipin mo. Kasi nakakaya naman kay Lord kung tuwingin ko, sakit ang ngipin, niloloko mo na yata ako. Tapos nakita ko sa Square One. Uy, ba't nandito ka? Bumili po ako ng gamot sa Shoppers. Eh, kumain na rin po kami. And then may sale, Pastor. Eh, pero tuwing linggo naman, ginagawa ko yun. Hindi ako niloloko mo. Sino niloloko mo? Si Lord. Di ba? Kaya sa inyo na parang sasakit ng Sabado ang ipin, Tylenol 3. Yung may mga masasakitan dyan, Imodium. Yung mataas ang blood pressure, aspirin, 81 milligram. Masakit ang paa, magpa-wheelchair. Huwag na magdahilan, because the Lord knows our heart. Amen po ba? Kaya sa linggo, kitakits ulit. We come to celebrate God's word, we come to communicate God's word. Lastly, out of the seven, I believe, is we gather to educate God's people. Ephesians chapter 4 explains that to us. We want to educate our people, God's people, for maturity. And by saying that, we need the right methods. God doesn't want us just to go to church. Let me repeat that. Sa inyo, medyo nahihimbing na kayo. God does not want us just to go to church. God wants us to be the church. Saan ka pupunta? Sa church. Amen. Pero church is not a building according to the Bible. Church is the body of Christ. That where we gather, God is there when we exalt His name. Amen? Amen? Don't just go to church, be the church. And I know to most of you, you love to have Bible study and fellowship. You are a church itself wherever you are. God is glorified to those who come with right intention. In closing, we're closing na, amen? Let me just tell you what John Wesley said about this, and I'll come back, Lord willing, with this. Let's review. We gather to communicate God's word by using a right message, the gospel. We gather to celebrate God's presence, that is worship. We gather to educate God's people, that is discipleship. I like it when John Wesley has said it with his words. Sabi ni John Wesley, nung buhay pa siya, I want the whole Christ for my Savior, the whole Bible for my book, the whole church for my fellowship, and the whole world for my mission field. You see, there is nothing in this world that will satisfy you. The truth of the matter is this, there is a God-shaped vacuum in our heart that nobody and nothing in this world can satisfy. Only God will. I encourage you to enhance your relationship. I encourage you to build up the fellowship. But there's only one thing that we can do is to come together and say, Lord, be the Lord and the Savior of all the aspects of my life. In relationship, in finances, or whatever we have there, He should be Lord of all. Or else, He will not be Lord at all. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. I pray that you have blessed your people. Thank you for the privilege of sharing to my brothers and sisters. I love this family of God, oh Lord. And we pray as we come around and study your word, may we be reminded what church is all about. Right now, we have a higher view of why we come and gather today. But I pray a prayer of blessing to this wonderful church, that let this church be established, let this church grow, and let, oh Lord, more people get to know you as their Lord and Savior. May the Lord bless you all. May the Lord keep you, and may He find us all faithful in our service for Him. To God be the glory alone, in Jesus' name, and all God's people say, amen and amen. Let's give the Lord a clap offering. Yes, Lord, we bless you for your word today. Amen.